I'm going to present a brief introduction to the equilibrium constant. Remember, the equilibrium constant is dimensionless, and this is important. So K is dimensionless, and of course this term in the exponential is dimensionless, where delta G is the change in the Gibbs free energy at standard state conditions. So let's look at a simple A goes to B plus C reaction. If we write down the equilibrium constant, we have to write it in terms of activities. Activity of B, activity of C, and then reactant, and the hat just indicating activity in solution in general. If this were 2A goes to B plus C, then the A activity in the denominator would be squared. Let's look at some special cases. First, let's look at the case of ideal gases. And for an ideal gas, the activity of B, which is going to be the ratio of the fugacity of B in solution, in the mixture, over the fugacity of B at standard state conditions for the pure component. Now, this is the general definition of activity, where it's an ideal gas or a liquid or a solid. If it's an ideal gas, then this fugacity in the mixture is going to be the partial pressure B. And the typical standard state is an ideal gas, pure component, at 1 bar pressure and the same temperature. And so the fugacity then, the pure component, is going to be 1 bar. And then the partial pressure would be the mole fraction times the total pressure divided by 1 bar. And so this would be the activity of B that we would substitute into this equation if all three are gases. So if A, B, and C are ideal gases, then our equilibrium constant, mole fraction of B, mole fraction of C, and then pressure squared divided by pressure, so we'd have pressure, where we have to keep in mind the pressure is in units of bar, and this is dimensionless. So if we're at a constant temperature, and we're looking at this same reaction, A plus B goes to C, and we were to increase the pressure, so if we somehow, piston and cylinder arrangement, for example, we raise the pressure, what this equilibrium expression tells us is this term must decrease, because this is a constant. At constant temperature, the equilibrium constant does not change. So increasing the pressure for this reaction sends the reaction back towards reactants. And that's what this equilibrium expression tells us. We decrease the mole fractions of B and C, and we increase the mole fraction of A. So let's look at the case where we instead have a liquid as one of the species. And so now, liquid phase, if component B is a liquid, well, its activity again is the ratio of fugacities. And the fugacity of component B would be the mole fraction, the activity coefficient to account for it being non-ideal mixture, the saturation pressure of B, and then we may have to have a correction if we're at very high pressures, a pointing correction. We're going to forget about that for now and assume we're at just moderate pressure, so the pressure is not affecting the fugacity of the liquid significantly. And the standard state is the pure liquid at the same temperature in 1 bar. So 1 bar close to an ideal gas, the fugacity is close to the saturation pressure. And so we can see that The mole fraction liquid phase times the activity coefficient is going to be activity. And the activity would be the mole fraction if we're an ideal solution. An ideal solution, then the activity coefficients are 1. If it were a pure liquid, let's assume B exists as a liquid and the other components are in different phases, then the activity of B, again, it's the fugacity of B in the mixture, but now it's a pure component. Fugacity of B at standard conditions, same temperature, so the only difference is the pressure. And if we're not at very high pressures, the fugacity does not change very much. So to reasonable approximation, the activity is 1 in the equilibrium expression. And we have the exact same thing if it's a pure solid. The activity of B, if it's a pure solid, is also approximately 1. So if we have, for example, a reaction where A is a solid, and B is a solid, and C is a gas, and A and B are immiscible. So they exist as 2 separate solid phases. That's critical. They're separate solid phases. Activity of B is then 1. The activity of A is also 1. And the equilibrium constant is just, and let's say it's an ideal gas, it's just the pressure of C times 1 and divided by 1. So the equilibrium constant pressure of C, where again we have to use units of bar because we understand it's the pressure of C divided by 1 bar. So for the case where the solids are not miscible, so A and B are solids that don't mix, equilibrium constant simplifies quite a bit.